In order to find the moment of a force having a magnitude of 80 pounds acting vertically upward about the x-axis, we first need to identify our reference axis. Here, I'm considering x prime, y prime, and z as the reference axis. Next, let's go ahead and write our triple scalar product. That is a product between three vectors that give us an scalar quantity. Starting with the very first vector is the unit vector of the direction across which we are calculating the moment. Next, I have a position vector r that starts from any point on the direction at which we are calculating the moment and heading towards the line of action of the force. And finally, we have the force vector. Next, let's go ahead and identify the unit vector of axis x. Since our reference axis is x prime and y prime, so I need to project our axis x along x prime and y prime, which we can do that by taking the cos 30 and sine 30 function respectively. Next comes the position vector. Since the idea of the position vector is its tail should be on the axis, in this case, I'm selecting point A as it lies on the x-axis as well, whereas its head should be on the line of action of the force. So in this case, we are considering point C as that head. So the required position vector in our case will be RAC. To get that, we can identify the point coordinates of C. So since the length of that A frame is of 6 feet, but it is tilted at an angle of 15 degrees on our Z and X prime plane. So in order to get our X prime component, we are taking the cos 15 function of 6, but since it is acting in the negative direction, that's why I have minus 6 cos 15, whereas the component along the y prime direction of point C is 3 feet, and the z component can be calculated by taking the sine 15 function. So the z component is 6 times sine 15. Once we have that, we can do head minus tail and identify our position vector RC. Finally, I have our force vector that is acting vertically upward along the z-axis. So the in terms of Cartesian form, the force vector is represented as ATK. Once we have all the three vectors, let's go ahead and plug that information in our expression. So our triple scalar product can be calculated using a determinant function in which the first row represents the unit vector of the axis across which we are calculating the moment, whereas the second row is our position vector and the third row of that determinant is the force vector. Next, we can go ahead and simplify that determinant to get our final moment that is coming as 440 pound feet.